Before we take a look at the algorithm, how to add or how to find the sum of natural numbers starting from 1 to n, we will take a look at the skeleton or the syntax diagram of the while do end while loop. So this represents the syntax of the looping or repetition using a while do statement. So while, do and end while, these are the key words which are written in blue. So as long as this condition is true, all the statements between while and end while are executed repeatedly till this condition turns out to be false. So if this condition continues to be true, these statements are going to keep on executing. The minute this condition becomes false, it will come at this point of time. So in order to get a good understanding of the while do, let's take a look at one more example. In this example, what I'm trying to do here is I'm trying to find the sum of natural numbers starting from 1 to n. If you look at the previous problem, what we did was, in the previous problem, all that I did was I was simply trying to print the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 till n. But now what I'm interested is I want 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 till the end value. So in order to have a sum of these natural numbers, I will require one variable to store the sum of that, called as sum, with the initial value 0. This initializing it to 0 is very important because it will be 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 till n. Then I need a starting number 1. Okay, I start the number from 1. And then I need the max or the end point called as n. So I need one variable number, I need one variable sum, I need the end point called as n or max. Now what I should be doing here is, it's quite simple. I should be taking the number and adding it to sum as long as the number is less than or equal to n. So I will take 1, add to sum, the sum is 1. Then I'll take 2, add to sum, sum is 1 plus 2, it becomes 3. Then I'll take 3, add to sum, it is 3 plus, past two numbers, 3 plus 3, 6. So this process keeps on going on. Now how long should this process keep going on? As long as the value of number is less than or equal to the maximum natural number n you desire. Okay. So the logic is going to be, at every step I am going to add the number to sum. 0 plus 1. Okay. Then number is going to be equal to 2. Then next time it is 1 plus 2. Okay. This process will keep on going as long as this particular fellow is less than n. So going through this logic, let us try to take a look at this particular program. So first I am defining one variable called as number, giving it the first natural number 1. Then n represents my end point or the last natural number till where I am interested to find the sum. And sum represents the sum of 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 it is going to store. So in order to find the sum, I only need to get n from the user. So I am going to say get n, read n, scan n, they all mean the same. So till this n, I need to keep adding the number. So what I am going to do here is, I am going to say, how long should I keep adding the number? As long as number is less than or equal to n. So here what I am doing here is, I am saying as long as number is less than or equal to n, I am saying sum is sum plus number, as I am doing here. Then number is increased by 1 so that it goes to 2. Then the old value of sum, 1 plus 2, is added. Then number becomes 3. This process keeps on going as long as the number is less than the or equal to the end point or the last number you want to find the sum till. Once this is found, I have to simply print the sum on the screen or on the printer. Now, as usual, we cannot trust our logic without running a test plan, because it will all look great on paper, but suppose by mistake if you had exchanged these two steps, you would have got a completely different answer. So in order to see how this particular chap works, let us run through a test plan. So what I am going to do here is, I am going to just assume n as 5, okay? I am just going to find the sum of 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5. Number is 1, sum is 0, n, I really don't care. Get n is going to be 5. Now how long should I continue to do these statements? As long as this fellow number is less than or equal to 5. So here in place of number it will be 1. In place of n, it will be equal to 5. 1 is less than or equal to 5. You come here. Sum is 0. So 0 plus 1. Number has not yet changed. 0 plus 1. Sum becomes 1. After sum becomes 1, number is increased by 1. Number becomes 2. After number becomes 2, I go back here. 2 is less than or equal to 5. Then sum is old value of sum 1 plus number. 1 plus 2, it becomes 3. Sum is 3. Number is in this step increased by 1, it becomes 3. Then I go back here. This condition is still true because 3 is less than or equal to 5. Sum is 3 plus 3. Sum is 6. Number here is 4. 4 is still less than or equal to 5. So I come here. Sum is 6 plus 4 is 10. Number is 5. Now 5 is not less than 5, but it is still equal to 5. So we are still okay. That means the condition is still true. So then sum is sum plus number. 10 plus 5 is 15. At this point number becomes 6. 6 is not less than or equal to 5. I will come here and I will print the message. Sum is sum. So you will get this on your screen. Sum is colon as it is. Whatever is in the double quote will come as it is. And then the number, whatever is the value in the variable sum will be printed, which happens to be 15. So with this, I hope you get an idea of how to find the sum of natural numbers using the while, do, end while syntax or end while construct. So whatever is between this while and end while keeps getting executed as long as this condition is true.